أوكي، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا، أما بعد. والله this issue brothers maybe in the last week or so I've heard it 20 times. والله 20 times. Me and some of the brothers were discussing it the other day as well. You lot are discussing a secondary issue, and the Muslims are being killed, are being slaughtered, are dying. Or the Prime Minister is coming and he's basically coming and doing this and he's doing that. So in other words, you lot need to understand that what you lot are doing basically has no significance. Busy yourself with the contemporary matters and speak about that. I believe this kind of question, you know, the Ummah is suffering and all you talk about is Mawlid, or all you lot talk about is Mawlid. These kind of questions are the reason why the Ummah is suffering. The reason why the Ummah is suffering today, okay, and there's so much problems, is because of questions like this. People don't know the solution. They don't know the solution. They believe that they have to start with the Muslim ruler, for example, rectify him and everything else becomes rectified. Na'am, if the Muslim ruler becomes rectified, some of the Salaf, they used to say, إِذَا صَلُحَ الْأَمِيرِ. If the Amir now, the ruler becomes rectified, صَلُحَ الْبِلَادِ وَالْعِبَادِ. Everything under him becomes rectified as well, without a doubt. But how do you go about solving the issue now? You can't get hold of the guy. He's not listening to you. What are you going to do? I'm asking you a question. What's the question? The answer. These kind of issues, brothers, wallahi, it basically gets brought up all the time. What is the solution for it? Who can tell me? حتى ترجعوا إلى دينكم جزاه الله خيرا. Hundreds and thousands of people come out on the streets protesting, doing what? Burning flags. People are burning flags at the embassy. They go to 10 Downing Street and they're burning flags, as if that's gonna solve anything. Hundreds and thousands of people are queuing up on the roads, at the embassies, trying to solve this. This issue has popped up. They've reverted to what? The ways of the non-Muslims in trying to solve a matter. If something goes wrong, people start protesting today. Everyone's on the road. They do something that has no basis in the religion. طيب. Salatul Fajr. Have you come to Masjid Quba and Salatul Fajr? MashaAllah, the masjid is packed, صح? All the way to the back. People are queuing up outside for the prayer. Is that the case? A basic fundamental, a command, basic fundamental that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded every single individual with, the salat. And then to apply that action where? Inside the masjid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then we expect and we ask this question, huh? And we say to ourselves, when is the suffering of the Muslims going to end? When is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala going to take this bala away? And we expect this. And we ask this question, when is this going to get sorted out? Basic fundamentals, wallahi, brothers, basic fundamentals from the religion today has been left off. What did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say? إِذَا تَبَايَعْتُمْ بِالْعِينَ. And then tell me if this is not applicable to the people here today. إِذَا تَبَايَعْتُمْ بِالْعِينَ. If you now start having transactions, types of riba, وَأَخَذْتُمْ بِأَذْنَابِ الْبَقَرِ, and you start chasing the tails of the cows, يعني الدنيا, وَرَضِيتُمْ بِالزَّرْعِ, وَتَرَكْتُمُ الْجِهَادِ, and you've left off jihad. The biggest form of jihad is what? Jihad with the Quran. People think as soon as the issue of jihad comes up, you have to pick up a knife or you have to pick up a gun and you have to start blowing things up. Allah says in the Quran, وَجَاهِدْهُمْ بِهِ جِهَادًا كَبِيرًا. Strive against them with the biggest form of striving, which is with the Quran. Jihad al-Nafs also is mentioned. You striving against yourself from the shaitan. Stopping yourself from these desires and these shubahat that are in front of you. It's another form of jihad. People only think that jihad is what? You pick up a gun, that's it. وَتَرَكْتُمُ الْجِهَادِ صَلَّتَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمْ عَدُوًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send down upon you lot a enemy. لَنْ يَنْزِعَ اللَّهُ عَنْكُمُ الْبَلَى حَتَّى تَرْجُعُوا إِلَى دِينِكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not uplift the problems that you have until when you come back to your religion. Tell me how many of the Muslims today, how many Muslims today, they are applying the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What is the opposite of sunnah? Bid'ah, innovation, something that has been introduced after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That one desires to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that has no basis in religion. Something that is more what? Beloved to who? The shaitan, than the ma'asi. People, they say, you got people say, people like Nu'man Ali Khan saying, wallahi, we need to talk about the real issues, the real issues. Things like drugs, things like, you know, zina, and talk about this and talk about that. That's the real issues. Well, I don't care. I don't care if you celebrate Mawlid or not. When the bid'ah is what? Western, the ma'asi, the so-called big issues that we hear. Why is bid'ah more beloved to the shaitan? Who can answer this question than the ma'asi? Huh? Na'am, the guy that's doing bid'ah, he carries on doing bid'ah, thinking what? That he's getting closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The guy that goes and fornicates with his girlfriend and he's a Muslim, he understands faqih, he's going to be regretful, he's going to remorse, oh wallahi, that, make tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And shaitan doesn't want that. As Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala mentions, that the bid'ah is more beloved to the shaitan than what? Than the ma'asi, because the guy carries on doing it. So how is one going to tell me now, you are just speaking about Mawlid, which is a bid'ah, goes against the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we need to talk about zina, we need to talk about this, we need to talk about that. You know, Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala, and pay attention to this. This is the solution. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentions in the akhir, the end of the kitab al-furusiyyat al-muhammadiyyah. Five things. مَجْتَمَعَتْ هَذِهِ الْخَمْسَ فِي قَوْمٍ. Never did these five things ever come collectively in a particular people. إِلَّا فَتَحُ الدُّنْيَا. The whole dunya opened up for them. What are these five things? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا لَقِيتُمْ فِئَةً فَثْبُتُوا. When you meet the enemy, be firm. وَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. And remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala much, perhaps that you become successful. What does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say after that? Two things I mentioned already. Third thing, وَأَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُوا الرَّسُولَ وَلَا تَنَازَعُوا فَتَفْشَلُوا وَتَذْهَبُ رِيحُكُمْ وَاصْبِرُوا. Obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَلَا تَنَازَعُوا. Do not dispute one another. And if you start disputing one another, what happens? You fail. The fifth thing is what? فَاصْبِرُوا. And be patient. وَأَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُوا الرَّسُولَ وَلَا تَنَازَعُوا. Obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's messenger. That's number three. Do not dispute amongst yourselves. وَلَا تَنَازَعُوا. It'll be the reason why you fail. And then the fifth one, فَاصْبِرُوا. Be patient. Are you with me? These five things. Never did it become or come collectively in a people except they opened the dunya. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala says that. دَانَتْ لَهُمُ الْعِبَادْ وَالْبِلَادْ. Everybody started listening to them. Things opened up for them when they apply these five things. Who can tell me or the meaning of when a person testifies that nobody has the right to be worshipped in truth other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the final messenger? Min muqtada that you believe in the Prophet sallallahu alayhi to be the final messenger and the seal of all prophets, from that which he means or in consist of, ta'atuhu fi ma amar, that you obey that which he has commanded to, wa tasdiquhu fi ma akhbar, and to believe firmly in that which he came with. وَإِجْتِنَابْ مَا نَهَى عَنْهُ وَزَجَرْ, and everything the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prohibited and criticized, you stay away from. basic things that the shahada consists of. That you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you do what he told you to do. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you do what he commanded you to do. And the opposite of sunnah is what? Is bid'ah, innovation, that the people keep doing. And then we expect that the bala is going to be lifted from the Muslims. And they carry on doing bid'ah, that people don't take seriously. Wallahi, that brings to mind the statement of Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu. إِنَّكُمْ لَتَعْمَلُونَ أَعْمَالًا هِيَ أَدَقُّ فِي أَعْيُنِكُمْ مِنَ الشَّعَرِ. You are going to be doing actions. You are going to be doing actions. You will see these actions more lighter or more thinner than a piece of hair. وَكُنَّا نَعُدُّهُ مِنَ الْمُبِقَاتِ فِي زَمِنِ النَّبِي صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمِ. And we used to see it to be from the destructive sins in the time of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Now tell me, brothers, are we not there at that time? He said that in his time. What about now? You are going to look at things, أخي والله مولد. أخي سهل. You see مولد to be correct, he sees مولد to be not correct. خلاص, let's move on. Let's agree to disagree. And then we expect that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to lift, uplift the bala upon the ummah. Let's agree to disagree. That's what we're basically hearing today. Wallahi, I believe that this is the reason why the ummah are suffering today due to statements like this. Are we not there at the time of what Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu said? Let's leave off these issues of bid'ah and things like that. And let's just concentrate on these particular matters. There's a hadith that talks about the mubiqat, the destructive sins. Hadith Abi Hurayn in Bukhari and Muslim. اجتنبوا سبع المبيقات. Stay away from the seven destructive sins. What was the first one? الاشراك بالله. That you associate partners of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today, what do we hear from Nu'man Ali Khan? Akhi, wallahi. People like Abu Isa Ni'matullah, they're saying, Kitab al-Tawheed is one of the most overrated books. All of these people, by the way, are together. Al-Maghrib Institute. The matters pertaining to Tawheed is being belittled. Where is Aqeedah written in the Quran? Where is Aqeedah written in the Quran? All you talk about is Shirk and Tawheed. Why is the Aqeedah so important? Why? Let's just talk about the real issues. Drugs, zina. Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhu, he said, لو أن لأحدكم مثل أحد ذهبا ثم أنفقوا في سبيل الله. If any of you had a mountain of gold, and then you spent it in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you gave it as charity. Ya khwan, have you seen Mount Uhud? Takes 4 or 5 hours to climb. Is that big? You had that in gold, and then you spent it in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ثم أنفقوا في سبيل الله ما قبل الله منه حتى يؤمن بالقدر. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not accept from you until you believe in the qadr. Qadr is one aspect of your aqidah, one aspect. Just because you're not believing in that is the reason why what? Nothing. You can have all the charity in the world, all the money in the world that you've given us charity, millions and billions. A guy that's fasting the siyam of Dawud alayhi salatu wasalam, the best form of fasting, قيام الليل, every night. But you don't believe in the qadr, or you believe that Ahmed is a prophet after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, which is just a form of the belief. Or you're cursing Aisha radiallahu anha. All of these are matters of the aqidah. Let's put that to the side. Let's just put aqidah to the side, just like that. The issue of tawheed is not given emphasis to. That's the first thing that was mentioned from the mubiqat. Al-ishraku billah. And wallahi, people, they belittle it to the next level. All you talk about is tawheed, shirk. What was the hadith that I mentioned to you time and time again? Even if the scholars were only speaking about tawheed and shirk. خير الدعاء دعاء يوم عرفة وخير ما قلت أنا والنبيون لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. The best thing that I ever said and those prophets before me is لا إله إلا الله. Tawheed. Even if the scholars were just speaking about that and nothing else. الإشراك بالله والسحر. سحر. Second thing that was mentioned in the Mubiqat. Today what? It's just normal. أخي والله, the girls, the daughters playing around with the one spell yam, huh? It's normal. We don't take it seriously. Keep remembering the statement of Anas ibn Malik رضي الله عنه إنكم لتعملون أعمالا هي أدق في أعينكم من الشعر وكنا نعده من الموبقات في زمن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. You lot do actions that you lot see it to be maybe more thinner than the or more lighter than the hair. And we used to see it to be from the destructive sins. And then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he goes into the kabair. وقتل النفس التي حرم الله إلا بالحق وأكل مال اليتيم وأكل الربا. All of these things, wallahi. And which is more greater? Bid'ah. One innovating in the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Innovation. Doing things like mawlid is more greater than all these major sins that are mentioned here. Because it's bid'ah. Wallahi, this kind of statement, it has opened up a wide door for our religion to become like the religion of the Christians. Where anybody comes and tampers with our religion, adds something, takes something out, huh? Tomorrow one guy is telling us we can do mawlid, just adds that to the religion, which in reality is khiyana. Imam Malik rahimahullah ta'ala says, "Man ibtada'a bid'atan fil Islam, yaraha hasana." Whoever now innovates an innovation in our religion and he sees it to be good, فَقَدْ زَعَمَ أَنَّ النَّبِيَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ خَانَ الرِّسَالَةَ. This person has claimed that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم has been treacherous. He has deceived. Why? Because Allah said, "الْيَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينَكُمْ." The day when I completed your religion. So how is one going to come today and add something to the religion? Are you not with me? What happened in the battle of Badr? لَقَدْ صَدَقَكُمُ اللَّهُ وَعْدَهُ إِذْ تَحُسُّونَهُمْ بِإِذْنِهِ حَتَّى إِذَا فَشِلْتُمْ وَتَنَازَعْتُمْ فِي الْأَمْرِ وَعَصَيْتُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا أَرَاكُمْ مَا تُحِبُّونَ. One sin that they did was the reason why they failed. Allah said, حَتَّى إِذَا فَشِلْتُمْ وَتَنَازَعْتُمْ فِي الْأَمْرِ. You failed and you started disputing amongst yourselves. وَعَصَيْتُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا أَرَاكُمْ مَا تُحِبُّونَ. And you disobeyed. After Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saw what you love, minkum man yuridu dunya wa minkum man yuridu al-akhira. From you are those that want the dunya and from you are those that want the akhira. One sin that they did was the reason of fashal. Imagine now we're in a state, the ummah, so much ijtama'at al-balaya. Bikulli anwa'iha wa ashkaliha. Everything is found amongst us. Zainab bin Jahsh says what? Anuhlaka wa fina salihun qala na'am idha kathru al-khabath. Will we become destroyed? And amongst us are the salihun. The righteous ones. The Prophet said yes. When the evil becomes widespread. Are you with me? When the evil becomes widespread, even the salihun, they will become affected. The salihun. People that have nothing to do with anything. When the earthquake comes, it's not going to say, Adnan, hey, you wait here. Fulan, let me take you out. The earthquake is going to come and take everyone. Are you with me? And because of what we do, time and time again, wallahi, we blame everyone. I recently heard a statement. A big, fat, obese guy goes to the doctor and the doctor tells him, Akhi, you've got these issues. Huh? What do you think he says? Akhi, obesity runs in the family. He blames the family. The doctor says to him, nobody runs in your family. Are you with me? Do you get the point? Nobody runs in your family. He's blaming him. All the time we look for excuses, blaming every single individual. Never do we blame ourselves. The ummah is suffering today because of what we've done, because of our actions. And then we wonder, wallahi, time and time again, we wonder, oh, we blame this guy, we blame that guy. Why is the ummah suffering today? Do you really think that if the ummah, every single one of them, put down what they were doing, they went back to the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they stayed away from sins, where do you think the next khalifa is going to come out of? If every house now, they decide to implement the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, most likely to come out from one of these places. A woman that's naked comes out, claiming or trying to defend Islam, naked, comes out protesting. A guy has shaved beard. His own children are doing sinful, disobedient acts. They're coming out on the streets. Why? According to what? خلافة. Let's establish the خلافة. People are coming out on the streets of Britain. خلافة, خلافة, خلافة. Why don't you establish a خلافة in your house first? Teach your family. Let the sunnah be seen. All this false concept of الخلافة. خلافة in Britain. خلافة in Britain. Does that even make sense? The Muslim countries, they don't have a خلافة. As you're saying, they're saying there's no خلافة in a Muslim country. But you come and you establish that here. And at the same time, there's so much sin. Your house is like a cinema. Day and night, خبث and بلايا has been washing there. وَجْعَلْ بُيُوتُكُمْ قِبَلًا. Make your house a place of worship. Place where the house, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is remembered. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will rectify the people. Start with yourself. If every house, imagine now in Highfields, every house, sunnah, then the next mantiqa, then the next mantiqa. And the Muslims are following the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What do you think is going to happen? The Muslims are going to get stronger and stronger and stronger. And you find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unites them upon the Quran, the sunnah. And one other thing I'm going to mention inshallah ta'ala, because one of the five things that I mentioned was, do not dispute. وَلَا تَنَزَعُوا. Someone might take this and implement in a totally wrong way. And this goes through as, ya akhwan, let's just unite. Their main priority is to unite, and that's it. So regardless of the guy cursing the Sahaba, cursing Aisha radiallahu anhu, this guy believes that Ahmed is a prophet after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as long as everyone's saying they're Muslims, we unite. This is another misconception, very, very dangerous. Brothers, listen up. Na'am, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. Hold fast to the rope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and do not disunite. We have to unite without a shadow of a doubt. Allah defames those who split amongst them. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ فَرَّقُوا دِينَ وَكَانُوا شِيعًا. Allah says, وَلَا تَكُونُوا مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. مِنَ الَّذِينَ فَرَّقُوا دِينَ وَكَانُوا شِيعًا. Allah says, أَنَقِيمُوا الدِّينَ وَلَا تَتْفَرَّقُوا فِيهِ. All these ayat. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ فَرَّقُوا دِينَ وَكَانُوا شِيعًا. لَسْتَ مِنْهُمْ فِي شَيْءٍ. Allah defames those who split amongst them. But we unite upon what? I tell the Rafidi guy who's cursing Aisha radiallahu anha after every salat, and I'm praying next to him, he's cursing the Sahaba and I'm praising the Sahaba, let's unite. Is that going to make sense? Al-ijtima'u ala al-kitabi wa sunnah ala fahmi salif al-salih. That one unites upon the Quran and the sunnah, upon the understanding of the Sahaba. Otherwise, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would have just united with the mushrikeen. When he came with his message, was he bare like, you know, watering down the manhaj and just compromising with them? Wallahi, that's fine. You worship your aliha. This is what they said to him. Let us worship our aliha one time, and then 1 year you can do it as well. They started saying, Muhammadun farraq al-nas, farraq al-nas, Muhammadun farraq al-nas. Muhammad came and he split the people. Na'am, he split them between haqq and batil. This is something that is very common, that you hear all the time, let's just unite. Na'am, unite. Upon what though? Quran, sunnah, upon the understanding of the Salaf. لَنْ يَنْزِعَ اللَّهُ عَنْكُمُ الْبَلَىٰ حَتَّى تَرْجِعُوا إِلَىٰ دِي. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not remove the bala, the fitna that you have, until you come back to your religion. And this is why the Muslim ummah is suffering today. Due to us, our sins, what we're doing, because we have become so far from the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then we expect the bala to be uplifted from the Muslimin. What does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say? And I'll conclude with two more ayat. And the cure is mentioned to us. Ya ikhwan, don't think to yourself that there's no cure. Or we need to go and maybe, wa yarhamukallah, uptake some of the ways of the non-Muslims in order to obtain salvation. La, every sickness that have come down, there's always a cure for it. مَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ دَاءً إِلَّا وَأَنزَلَ مَعُهُ شِفَاءً. Never did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send down a sickness except that the cure is with it as well. يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ قَدْ جَاءَتْكُمْ مَوْعِدَةٌ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ وَشِفَاءٌ لِمَا فِي الصُّدُورِ. It's in the Quran. The Quran is a shifa, a cure. What does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say to us? وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised those who have believed. And pay attention here. The cure is in this ayah for any mushkila within the Muslim ummah today. وعد الله الذين آمنوا منكم وعملوا الصالحات. Second thing is what? Those who do good deeds. لا يستخلفنهم في الأرض. What is the best deed that one can do? التوحيد بالله عز وجل. And today is being belittled. لا يستخلفنهم في الأرض. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will establish them upon the earth. كما استخلف الذين من قبلهم, just like he established those before him. وليمكنن لهم دينهم الذي ارتضى لهم. And he will make them firm upon the earth. When يعبدونني لا يشركون بي شيئا. When you start worshipping me and you do not associate partners with me. You establish tawheed. You worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the sunnah, not with bid'ah. Because as soon as you start worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with other than its way, what happens? You fall into bid'ah. And then someone comes up to me today and he says to me, why are you disputing the issue of mawlid? And this is happening and that's happening. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, He will not change the state of the people until they change themselves. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide these people who have a big following. People like Yasir Qadi, Nu'man Ali Khan, thousands of people, and then you come out with statements like, أخي والله, I don't care if that guy is, I don't care if someone is celebrating Mawlid or not. As if that's a minor issue. Again, Anas ibn Malik, إِنَّكُمْ لَتَعْمَلُونَ أَعْمَالًا هِيَ أَدَقُّ فِي أَعْيُنِكُمْ مِنَ الشَّعَرِ. You will do actions that you see lighter or more thinner than hair in front of your eyes. وَكُنَّا نُعُدُّهُ مِنَ الْمُبِقَاتِ. Abu Musa al-Ash'ari, just brought to my mind, Abu Musa al-Ash'ari and Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, when they saw them people counting pebbles in the masjid, counting pebbles in the masjid. كَبِّرُوا مِيَا وَسَبِّحُوا مِيَا. Make takbir 100 and do tasbih 100. Did Abu Musa al-Ash'ari take that lightly? And Abdullah ibn Mas'ud? Abdullah ibn Mas'ud became severe with them. Got angry at them. He told them that the clothes of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his pots and his pans are still intact. And you lot have started doing this when you have the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam around you? Did they take the issue of bid'ah lightly? Did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam take the issue of aqidah lightly? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam one time came and some of the companions, they were disputing regards to the issue of al-qadr. Abi hadha amartukum? Is this what I commanded you with? His face, they say, went red like pomegranate. Rumman. When they started disputing regards to the issues of al-aqidah. And then you want us to come today and just leave of these matters, matters pertaining aqidah and bid'ah, and just put it to the side and call it, you know, sub-branches or subsidiaries, you know, these secondary matters, they're not that important. We've got other things on our plate. Wallahi, I believe that statements like this are the reason why the Muslim ummah is suffering today. Imam Malik rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُصْلِحُ آخِرِ هَذِي الْأُمَّةِ إِلَّا مَا أَصْلَحَ أَوَّلَهَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not rectify those that come in the later times with anything except with that which rectified the people before them. So if the people want to solve these issues, then go back and check what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did. How the Sahaba ridwanullahi alayhim fatahu ad-dunya, Umar ibn al-Khattab. Nahnu ummatun, and he said, nahnu ummatun a'azzana Allah bil Islam. We are people Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given honor through what? Al-Islam. Wa mahma btaghayna ghayra al-Islam yadhallana Allah. And when the people, they start taking other than Islam as a way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will humiliate them. What happened in the land's Arab Spring? When the Muslims, they started protesting and taking the ways of other than the Muslims. And you don't know the hadith, you studied it time and time again. Sam' wa ta'a. The Muslims today are living in humiliation. They can't do nothing. They're so left what? Ta'atu an-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What did we mention before? Actions. doing what the Prophet ﷺ told you to do. He told you to stay in your home and to listen and obey. That hadith when the Prophet ﷺ said, there will come a time, أُمَرَاءٌ لَا يَقْتَدُونَ بِهَدِي وَلَا يَسْتَنُّونَ بِسُنَّتِي. They won't take my guidance as a guidance and they won't take my sunnah as a sunnah. قُلُوبُهُمْ كَقُلُوبِ الشَّيَاطِينَ فِي جُثْمَالِ الْإِنسِ. Their hearts are like the hearts of the shaitan in the body of an ins. So what do we do? وَإِنْ ضُرِبَ ظَهْرُكْ وَأُخِذَ مَالُكْ فَاسْمَعْ وَاطِعْ. If he beats your back, takes your money, listen and obey. The Prophet told us to do that. What did the Muslims do? They decided to take other than the path of the Muslims. And now, for everybody to see, we're being left out. The Muslims are living in humiliation. Simply because of what? They went away from what the Prophet ﷺ told them. And it's simple as that. Simple as that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best.